Now, if there's one thing in my life that I'm really proud of about myself, it's that I'm vegan. Or at least try my best to be vegan. Because recently, there's been some compromises here and there, which is, you know, for the most part of this experience of my vegan journey, I haven't had that many failures or compromises. But recently, I've made a lot. I think I've made the most compromises in the past 3 weeks than I've ever done in my whole vegan journey. And I've been vegan about, 2.5 years now? A little more, actually. So, it feels like a huge accomplishment. I know, you know, for majority of people, at least in the Western world, like Europe and America, where meat eating is such a big culture. Like if you go to India, it wouldn't be as big of a deal because majority of the population there have vegetarian diets. But I guess here, where you know the fast foods are so commonplace, and where Food Network, if you look at like all the shows, yeah, like vegetarian is considered like freak diet. So I guess here it's in America. It feels a bigger achievement to me. I mean, I am in New York City, which is one of the most vegan-friendly places in America. So there's that going on for me. So, but yeah, it's something I'm really proud of. I'm not saying that to like rub it in anyone's faces or anything. I know it. You know, whatever reasons, it's tough. It's not easy to you know. Get to that lifestyle, and you also need to find a cause. Like, why the hell would I even consider being vegan? So, if you don't have that reason, you know, I totally understand. But for me, this has been quite an incredible journey, and I don't have a good self-esteem on many of the other aspects in life. So, this is that one thing. I'm just like, yeah, you know, every day, every meal I eat, you know, this is the values that I believe in, and I'm doing it every day. This actually makes me feel super good. But the compromises I've been making is because of the financial situation I've been in recently. I mentioned before that I lost my job like 4 or 3 months ago. Not quite sure on the actual details there. Yeah, I lost my job. I had enough money though. I got a good amount of money to last me for quite a while. But I didn't last long enough because like 3 weeks ago, I look at my bank account, there's $20 in there. I go to grocery shopping without knowing that. I do my grocery shopping, I swipe my debit card, and it's denied. I'm like, whoa, what's going on? Okay, and the lady's like, try again. I swipe, it's denied. I'm like, crap, I know what this might be about. So I get out my iPhone, go to my bank account app, check it out, and it's just like $20. And my grocery is, the things I picked out is $30. So, crap. So I had to take out $10 worth of stuff. It's mostly processed stuff that I really enjoy, like ketchup or whatever. Ketchup and jam and peanut butter. So those are expensive. So I just took, you know, fresh fruits and veggies, which are usually a lot cheaper. And I also had dressing in there because now I have to eat salad without any kind of dressing. But yeah, so $20, so I'm up with like nothing in my bank account. And I have 2 weeks to survive till my paycheck, which will be my first paycheck since being unemployed. And I actually got that paycheck today. So that was quite the, today being October 26, of course. That was quite awesome. But yes, I had to survive 2 weeks without money. I had to ask my mom for a $300 loan there, and she had to kind of finesse her way around that because my parents' money situation ain't so hot either. But there's no way. I got $300, but that's like emergency fund. There's no way I'm touching any of that. So I'm left in this really horrible situation. And I'm canvassing, so I can't like, you know, it's easier when I'm at home because I can cook food for myself. Canvassing, I'm out like 12 hours until I come back home. Yeah, it's been challenging in that way. There is still, you know, places that we go to, I guess, that can still be vegan. I could take, like, carrots and kale with me, and I just eat them raw. One canvassing night, I took a tomato, and I just dive right into that after a couple hour canvassing. So I've still managed to be vegan for the most part. The compromises happen every Wednesday for the past 3 weeks, because Wednesday is free pizza nights. I can't eat pizza from a pizza store because it has cheese. But that was a compromise I had to make. You know, it's been little compromises like that. You know, free food, which I would normally decline because of my vegan values, I couldn't this time. That was I wouldn't say it was a blow, it was a huge blow or anything, but it didn't feel good. You know, it's just like, this is the situation I'm in, and I have to, you know, make compromises. I have to be vegetarian on Wednesdays. pretty crazy. That was interesting, you know, but it doesn't, you know, there's a lot of people who become vegan or become vegetarian, and they have that 1 week or 1 day where they fail, and then they just revert back to being non-vegetarian or non-vegan. Maybe they eat less meat than before, but that like one time or 1 week is it for them. And, you know, I think that's kind of the wrong mindset if you try to become a vegetarian or vegan. It's no one's asking us to be perfect. We are human, you know? I mean, 23 years of my life, I was not a vegetarian or vegan. Like, how, you know, I can't make up for that. The course of life is to try to be as best as you can be. The principle of veganism is not being this ultra-perfect guy who does, you know, who like, perfectly follows his values, or her, you know, his, because I'm talking about me, perfectly follows his values to the letter, and then once that fails, oh shit, I screwed the whole thing up, I can't do it anymore. It's not like that. The principle is to do as least harm as possible. So, yeah, maybe I'm still doing some harm. There's still a lot of things that I need to cut. Like, this wallet I have is made of leather, you know, and I still have it. But I can't really afford right now a wallet that is not made of leather, but of synthetic materials. So, yeah, no, it wouldn't be right to label me as, like, a pure vegan. But no one is. Like, in this world, it's so hard to be this pure vegan. I'm using this computer right now, and I'm pretty sure it has done some kind of animal cruelty to get it made. So, just by using this, I'm not this pure vegan. But that's okay, because this is a journey. It is not this one, like, perfect performance thing. The point is to do least harm as possible, and whatever way we can try and succeed at that's what matters. You know, if you see a video that you know, shows how chickens are slaughtered and whatever, and you're like, oh my god, I can no longer eat chicken, but you know, everything else is good for you, and you cut chicken out, that's still progress. You know, I don't see it as a pass or fail kind of thing. Most of life is not pass or fail. It's a scale. You know, how well are you doing on this scale? That's what matters. And right now I'm like on that scale. These past 3 weeks I haven't been doing as good as I wanted to, but that's the life circumstances. And I guess the important thing to remind myself and other, you know, people who are vegans or vegetarians or trying to be, is that we're on a scale. It's not a pass or fail test. You know, we will have failures, but they're not the end all. You know, just gotta keep going and just gotta keep doing our best.